No, no, but
I
you
know,
agitated with an
widely
equal
understood,
amount of
which is
ferocity against the Dabol Power project, Rahul, and then went and signed an agreement with the Enron executives. I also want to, Dr. Singh, we just bring in the other experts. Okay, Dr. Singh, very quickly, then we got two other panelists I want to go to.
Yeah, very quickly. I'm sorry, my friend on the panel is completely wrong on each count. We in India have taken a long time over 1, 2, 3 after full democracy and parliament. We have taken a long time over a nuclear civil liability bill. We have taken a long time over this project. And if we had no democracy,
Dr. Singhvi,
and if
like
we had
to
the fascism,
you that
which
colleagues from your party
which,
have come
one
on
minute, one minute, one,
that
one
this
minute,
bill needs
one
to be
minute,
deliberated
one
further.
One minute.
So,
and
so
if we
I
did not have democracy in this country, and if we had,
representing the facts.
If we did not have the democracy
so,
in this
you,
country,
you are very well free to do that on the floor of the parliament,
the Sena,
but you should not do that on national media and misguide the people at large.
This is not fair. This is not fair. You please don't outshout me. If you have any substance in your arguments, please listen me out. If we had the fascism of
no,
the system and
you
not
are,
the democracy
you are
of India, you will not have the opportunity
of this country.
To say all this. You will not have an opportunity to say all this. In China, they wouldn't ask you 10 times. In Britain, they wouldn't have half as much natural justice as there is in this country. And it is the Shiv Sena, which is well known for being intolerant and fascist, not democracy of India. So don't attack democracy of India. We have a lot of democracy and transparency. And let me remind
that's
you,
exactly what
you've
done in the last couple of days. That's exactly
wrong.
What your government has done
actually
in the last
wrong.
Couple of days in Jaitapur.
Okay, gentlemen, just let me intervene over here. I want to bring in the experts on the panel. I want to go across to Dr. Balachandran. Jairam Ramesh announced publicly that there is a need for us to investigate. Let the investigation be complete. Then we'll take a call on whether we should go ahead with the Jaitapur project in its current form or split it up into smaller units. Do you think that's the right approach? Should we wait? Or do you think what the government is doing is okay?
But what investigation was Dr. Jairam speaking about? The only investigation about Fukushima can be done by... Look, what they all said was, and which is what China also said, they will look at the results of when they analyze what happened at Fukushima. They will take the lessons from that and they will apply. They did not say they are going to stop nuclear power plant. That's what our government, and I think that's what presumably Jairam Ramesh also meant. That we'll investigate what happened. Not we cannot investigate what happened in Fukushima. When the Japanese Nuclear Agency and the IAEA examine what happened in Fukushima and they make certain recommendations and certain guidelines, we'll follow that.
Okay.
That's all he said.
Vinuta Gopal.
And,
the point
what is wrong
that's
with
being
that?
Made by Dr. Balachandran is there is no need to put everything to a complete halt right now. We can assess as we go along the lessons from Fukushima and implement them in the Jaitapur PRA project.
Where
would
needed.
You think that would be a fair, rational approach, madam?
First of all, the government has to come clean on the steps it's taking as with regard to the assessment that they're currently undertaking. It's entirely shrouded under the same kind of secrecy that all nuclear issues are. I would also like to come back to the point that the public hearing in Jaitapur was a sham, and therefore the people's voice in Jaitapur has not been heard properly so far by the state. And the Chief Minister of Maharashtra would certainly do well to actually listen to his people about what they want and what they don't want in Jaitapur. So that process hasn't happened. And if the state suppresses the feelings of the people, then this is the kind of thing you're going to see in Jaitapur. Fukushima has shown us quite clearly that nuclear energy is inherently risky. There are safe options for us to adopt. For example, let me just talk about facts. Jaitapur, which is our biggest nuclear reactor park that we are planning, the first phase of it, which will come, Mr. Singhvi said, in 2018, and that is 1,650 megawatts. Now, if we wanted to generate that power this year, we could if we wanted to put up wind plants. Okay, we could if we wanted to just even do efficiency. If we changed every bulb that's used in India, we would generate 12,000 megawatts.
Okay,
and that's going to happen faster.
Yes.
That's safe.
Dr. Balachandran,
what
you're saying, Dr.
Balachandran. So why are we going after dangerous technology?